ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. Gonna find you and take it slowly. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. Gonna find you and make you want me.
Hello, it is Larissa MB Sue, and we're gonna type Lauryn Hill. So yeah, I feel like everyone should know who Lauryn Hill is, but maybe people don't. She's a singer and an actress and a writer. I mean, I think she was the head of like the Fugees. Mm-hmm. She's in Sister Act 2, one of my favorite movies. We're not 100% solid on her type at this point. But we could like make inferences, I guess, from looking at her in some photos. It's usually like one gut or eight gut, whether that's fixer or core, that go bald. Like the women, they shave off their heads. I don't know if that's like a good data point though. And she has like a brightness kind of to her face, like, which could point to her being social dom potentially.
Yeah, and I mean, she seems very camera aware, not in like a gross three way, but like in like a social kind of way.
Oh, I like that distinction, because yeah, there's something about her style too that doesn't really say like image type to me. She's got her own distinct style, but it seems like more from maybe like her soul or something than like an image construction. For, not that image types don't dress from their soul, but like it more just seems like it's part of her personality or something than to create an effect, perhaps. Oh, so yeah, she gives a speech. The speech gives me a bit of Social Self-Pres vibes, but I don't know. I guess the very nature of giving a speech is Social Self-Pres.
Right.
Oh, also even just the title, Lauryn Hill dropping truth to the youth, like that almost seems like, okay, that's probably like a 60 influenced.
Good afternoon, everybody. Wait a minute. Good afternoon. Contrary to, I don't even know if this is popular opinion, but, you know, contrary to the opinions of others, I don't think I'm cool at all. I definitely didn't grow up thinking I was cool. I was pop.
That's like some social sixy contexty. I don't think I'm cool. And I'm going to tell you a little backstory about why I'm not cool.
But not because I was cool, probably because I had a certain amount of independence and self-confidence from a young age. That's probably what made me cool, because I...
Like, anecdotal perhaps, but I do think, like, the sixes that have, like, an eight fix or even a one fix, they do have more confidence. Like, they, like, she's making a six self-effacing joke, but six, like, it's mostly 6-9s that are the ones that are like kind of the more sad sack. I'm a loser and I'll just keep on that track, and then she sort of rebounds it.
Yeah, that is actually interesting. 6-9s is such less, so like, I'm a loser, like, I'm the worst, like, everything's so, I'm like the absolute most rotten, like, piece of shit. And like 6-8 is like a very actually confident mix, generally speaking. I find like the eight grounds like the six, so they actually have like more like mental confidence.
Yeah, it kind of takes the like the losery part of it and makes it more like just humble or like humility more than.
I always wore like funny clothes, and kids were always like, what does she have on? What is that? What are those shoes? Why'd you put those shoes with that shirt? That doesn't match. You know, and then I'd go, you know, it's cool. And then like 3 or 4 months later, they'd have it on. And I said, but wait a minute, you said that my shoes didn't match my shirt.
I've been trying to track typologically what types consistently do this kind of thing, where it's like, I did it first because I can do that. But I've noticed it's six heads consistently, whether it's a fix or whatever, like they I noticed they like to point out, like, if they did something first.
I think it can be 6, 3, or 4.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Four. I'm actually, because, like, I don't know. Fours like to think they did everything first. And they get really mad if you, like, relate to them. Even if you're, like, I'm relating to you based on something, like, a concept I've brought up before you ever did. So, I don't know. I think it could be any of those.
And they say, well, no. So I just it's so funny. Every time I hear someone read, I guess, my resume or the things that I've accomplished, I always sort of feel embarrassed because.
Okay, this is some 6'3" shit. To me, whether it's 3 firsts or 6 firsts, it's like, I'm going to talk about my accomplishments, but I'm doing it with humility. It's like a way to sneak in the 3 accolades, but like.
My accomplishments to be proud of, you know. I'm not even a person who speaks well, you know. So to be invited to these types of events always overwhelms me because without the power of God behind everything I do, I really am completely inadequate. I fumble. I always drop the ball every time I try to prepare something.
It's like I've said this like a bunch of times, but 6'8" seem to have some weird thing with God where it's like, and I think it is sort of like that weird way of like sixes outsourcing in the head center, like they're taking charge of what of their own destiny and their life, and they're making decisions for themselves, but there's still this whole thing about not really being able to do it, so it's God who's doing it, like. Because I know you could say
The reason I was so curious to hear her finish her thought is like, sorry. The beginning of her thought was something like I could see myself thinking, you know, but it would be because I was like curious, is she coming from a 3-4 space where it would be like, you know, my resume is embarrassing. These aren't even my accomplishments. And it's like, because that was all bullshit and that's like not really me. And, is just like average or like whatever, but then she instead takes it in a totally different direction and is like, you know, feeling like humbled like there's, you know, spiritually empowered or something, which is like different from what the 3-4 like mix would do, because I had seen her typed in the past as like a 4-wing 3. So I was like trying to see that, but I'm like not seeing that. So
no. I entertained like image core for her when I was watching stuff on the cursed call that never actualized. But no, I'm leaning 6 core at this time.
Yeah, definitely. I'm getting 6-wing 5 with an 8-fix. But I'm curious on the image fix, if it could be 2, just.
You know, I stutter, I stumble, and, you know, what I say is of no effect. But what I found is that every time that I pray before I speak and I ask God for the confidence and that he be glorified in everything that I say and everything that I do, for some reason, words just come out of my mouth, so. Please don't be convinced by what people say. I'm not brilliant. I'm not a genius. I'm not even gifted, really. I mean, I have gifts, but these are things that all come from God and through me.
I mean, I guess I can see why someone might be like, oh, that sounds like 4. Like she's saying like, I'm not this, or like, I'm not good at this, or blah, blah, blah. But like, this is just kind of 6.
I don't see that as like 4 at all though, because she's,
no, but I mean, like,
I guess there are religious cores, but it's that. Like she's saying everything comes through some like external entity that's like giving her this power. Mm-hmm. Whereas I think with like 4, like 3, it's more like I happen to like work hard and get lucky, and I'm not particularly necessarily special, even though I think I'm super special at the same time. Which is just not what I'm like getting from her.
Yeah, and that's a good distinction, is like when it's coming from the image center, the reactive self-deprecating shit is more like to paint a picture of how special they are, not how not special they are.
Right.
Yeah.
And it's like, but it's a weird like mix of like, I'm going to downplay like certain stuff that is conventional, like resume stuff and like routine, like accomplishments, because that's not what's really important to me. Like I have some like higher like goals that I'm achieving. But anyway, getting off course, I am getting very good, like six wing five, like a cool six wing five. Like I wonder, like cool, all six wing fives are cool. I love six wing five. But like very like of the people and like earthy, grounded. But seeing herself like very much in relation, you know, to other people, to society, to her accomplishments, whatever. But I'm curious about her stacking, but we can get to that later.
I'm 25 years old, which means that we're not separated, you know, by a lot of years. I remember high school like it was 15 minutes ago. And I remember my high school graduation. I didn't get to go because I was on a set of Sister Act 2. And like, you know, everybody was kind of like, you know, you're filming a movie. Why are you upset? But I was really, really distraught. I was really hurt that I couldn't make it back to my high school graduation, because I realized that it was, those things were like so important to me, you know, beyond the, you know, all of the films and the media and the music and the industry things. I really appreciated my friends. I really appreciate.
Yeah. I think that does point to six wing five core again.
Mm-hmm.
Not here for the Hollywood.
Yeah. I mean, I'm getting six for sure. And I still am wondering about like a 6-2 stem because of that. Like, even though I think she has the 8 fix, like she has a lot of just kind of power and presence. 6-2 feels very much like the type that's like cares about high school graduations and like connections to back home.
I don't know. I mean, I would go do a talk about. Here's what not to do. I don't know. I don't get too energy out of her, but if I could like see it in action, maybe like there's, we can keep watching this or we can watch her interacting with people, maybe.
No.
Thank you very much. I want to do something. This may be a little bit different from the for the Grammys, but I'd like to read something. This is Psalm 40. I waited patiently for the Lord. He turned to me and heard my cry. He lifted me out of the slimy pit, out of the mud and mire. He set my feet on a rock and gave me a firm place to stand. He put a new song in my mouth, a hymn of praise to my God. Many will see and fear and put their trust in the Lord. Amen.
I know this is reductive again, but like 3-6-8s are just so into this shit for some reason.
I'm just so getting 6-5, 8-9, 2-1.
Where?
So much. I don't, her image seems very, it's strong. Like 2-1 is very strong and like grounded in their self-image, unlike some other image types that are more flaky or like floaty. But she has that like, so 6-8-2 I see as kind of like a mama bear or like strong earthy kind of person. I don't see 3-6 like at all, and 4-6 not really either, but I think 2-1 makes sense.
2-1? I don't see 2-1 like at all. Like 2-1 as an image is like matronly, you know.
But she's, I mean, she can still be, you, 2-in-1 fixes can still be like cool or like dress what, you know, and have like be artsy and whatever, like any type can be, but her image is just like very humble. Like she doesn't go up there and even try to, you know, even from even knowing it's not her core type, but from a fixed perspective, she's not trying to like really make herself like, you know, promote herself in any way, which is like a very, to me, a pointer to 2-in-1. They're very like not like self-promotional, whereas almost in almost all the other image fixes are, except maybe 4-in-5 to like some degree, but 2-in-1 seems like the least like kind of like self-promoting.
I'm gonna look to see if she has an
image. You know, she goes up there and reads a psalm, like she doesn't even like say her own thing or like put herself out there. It's like she has a higher calling.
I'm trying to be open. I like 2 with an 8 though, that's like, that's an intrusive stem. That's she doesn't seem, I don't know. I mean, I see what you're saying, but like about like there's kind of the super ego-y
She has like a very like take me or leave me quality that I think sometimes other image fixes like want to convey, but that they fail to in some way, or they leak their you know, need for worship or praise or whatever. But she's just very, and like to me, like 6-in-5, 8-in-9, and 2-in-1 are like very, all very grounded like types. And I wonder if she's like that, those like very grounded types, but like a social sexual or something that like lightens it up a little bit.
She seems like social self-pres as fuck to me. I'm like,
she did it. Her like she seems to like now that I've seen like a couple of videos, I mean granted I should watch more, but it doesn't seem necessarily like a consistent agenda or like whatever. It's more opportunistic, like getting social thoughts across, and very, she does seem very like to connect with the audience in like some kind of personal way. Like she has this like very like she's very like attuned to the reception of the audience and really trying to connect with them. Whereas I see social self-pres more kind of you know, just a broadcasting to the audience and not necessarily having like that feeling of being like receptive.
You guys are so close. Did she tell you why she stopped making out? You just felt uninspired.
Nah, Prod. People just don't feel uninspired when they are literally one of the greatest musicians of their time. And when it comes to Lauryn Hill, a lot has been said about the real reason why she was forced to quit music. Like, what exactly went wrong? Was it her relationship with Wyclef when he was married? Was it her attitude and offensive comments towards white people? Or was it that lawsuit that drained her? Or that cult leader who pulled her away from everyone and everything? I mean, geez, I have seen some downfalls.
She got pulled in by a cult leader. That might be too sexy. Oh, yeah, I heard that she might have said it. I don't know. She doesn't want white people to listen to her music, but I think she said that before it was de rigueur. So I feel like that makes her more interesting.
But this
is kind of
one messed up fall from literal greatness. And before we even get to how her downfall was devastating, we have to talk about how great she really was, just so you get it. So the first experience on a big stage for Lauren wasn't the best.
I'll tell you, I promise this is going to be an exciting amateur night. So let's bring out our next contestant. Give the nice Apollo welcome to Lauren Hill.
At just 13 years old, she decided to take her talents to the Apollo stage in New York City to sing Jackson 5's Who's Lovin' You. Unfortunately, her nerves got the best of her, and as she struggled to get her act together, she was eventually booed off the stage. However, just...
Who the fuck boos a child? Like, what kind of rotten mob of, like, just the most horrifying people on the planet? That's, like, just disturbing.
Despite the incident, she did not give up. And while in high school, she joined a hip-hop music group, the Fugees, founded by her Haitian friend, Praz. The initial members were him and a girl named Marcy, who brought Lauren into the group, then Praz's cousin, and Wyclef joined the group around a year later. Together, they somehow managed to balance their studies while recording demos and landing pretty neat gigs. And three different labels even offered them record deals by the end of that school year. Lauren also landed acting gigs like Sister Act 2 alongside Whoopi Goldberg. Unfortunately, just like with other artists, Lauren had to pay the price for fame, and it included controversy that I believe contributed to her downfall. The first time Lauren was hit with controversy was when rumors started circulating that she had made some comments about white people, saying that she would rather die or have her kids starve than to have them listen to her music. And that right there is credited as one of the reasons.
I mean, that seems like a little like a reactive. So she got reactive.
While Lauren's career started going south. Now, she did try to clear up the rumors while she was on Howard Stern's radio show, saying,
I think that it was probably taken out of context. What I was saying is that I make my music for young Black youth because I'm a young Black youth myself.
Despite the controversy at the time, the
I'm open to this two-wing, one-fix idea. Mm-hmm. Because that is sort of like the youth pastor, two-wing, one, just right. And I could maybe see that getting her into more trouble than like a three fix, mm-hmm. but
they disbanded during the height of their success. According to Lauren's former manager, it had to do with creative differences, with Lauren herself saying, I intended to be in the group forever until I found myself in circumstances where I felt the inner desire to express myself freely and openly without any constraint. Well, personal conflict between Lauren and Wyclef may have also played a role in the split. And some people also say that Wyclef is the reason why Lauren doesn't have a career.
It's hard, you know, it's hard balancing and juggling. It's hard, you know, being, the regular person that you are one day and the next day being under public scrutiny, you know, having to live your life, you know, in front of a camera.
You know, many people forget that Lauren was only 23 years old and pregnant when the first album was released, and people over expecting her to be better after that in her situation only made things worse. Then there was a lawsuit that just drained the life out of her. So what had happened was that New Ark Entertainment claimed that they were not properly credited for their work on Miseducation. And they...
Yeah, also like Miseducation is like, seems like a real sexy title.
Yes.
Like, you taught me wrong.
Took Lauren Hill to court. The suit was settled out of court with Lauren paying them $5 million, but apparently the situation and the process left her emotionally scarred, and because she was also under a lot of pressure to do better, Lauren drifted further and slowly disappeared. From there, things only got worse. When Lauren started associating with a spiritual advisor called Brother Anthony, who allegedly practiced real cult stuff, apparently Anthony convinced Lauren to sever ties with her management, colleague, and friends, damaging her career in the years after initially meeting in 2000. And when she resurfaced in 2001 on her MTV Unplugged 2.0, she performed alone and with damaged vocal cords. and the record was a commercial disaster. Apparently,
oh, that's really sad. I didn't know that all that happened.
Yeah, me neither.
You know, that does sort of speak to a 2-6 arc in some ways. Mm-hmm. Like, taken in by a cult, becomes like the victim.
Mm-hmm.
Wrecks her beautiful gift. Self-sacrificing.
Yeah.
Hmm. Good catch.
Apparently, during the performance, she referenced Brother Anthony a lot and even said things like, I started to see that my concept of spirituality was totally wrong. Real religion is no religion at all. Truth is the true covering. And when I started to see that, two things happened. My creativity came back in an overflowing abundance, and I got into direct confrontation with everybody I love. Then she went to Miami to attempt to record the second solo album, reportedly asking potential collaborators to do it for God, which meant do it for nothing. At some point amid craziness, the Fugees got back together, and after realizing there was still a spark to them, they met together in the studio and planned their new album. However, their reunion was short-lived due to the same old issues, and they split again. At the time, there were also comments regarding Lauren's mental health, and people believed that she was bipolar and that she was in need of dire help. That's how people also started saying that her mental health possibly contributed to her fall. Everything just continued going south from there, because in 2012, Lauren was charged with tax evasion for failing to pay $1.8 million in federal taxes back in 2013. And
you go, girl. I'm still trying to like focus on like the heart stuff. I don't see you doing like a lot of the nurturing, giving to thing, but it kind of would account for like the extra level of churchiness.
Yeah,
I don't think she's.
I felt it in her speeches. Even like I got the 6, but I also got like I did get a sense of 2, where like to me she seemed like honestly caring, like.
Hmm.
I don't want to say 2 is more like genuinely caring than the others, but like I don't know, just a kind of like a somewhat like mama bear like type vibe.
Hmm.
First of all, she started by saying, the wild thing is, no one from my label has ever called me and asked, how can we help you make another album? Ever, ever. Did I say ever, ever? She also said that while Miss Education offered her the freedom to experiment, the pressure of putting out a sophomore album that would live up to the first hype was enormous, adding, after the Miss Education, there were scores of politics, repressing agendas, unrealistic expectations, and saboteurs everywhere. People had included me.
Thanks.
Their successes as it pertained to my album. And if this contradicted my experience, I was considered an enemy. In short,
if you think about Kanye West, like 3 Wing 4 6 8 or 8 6, like he has a lot of this kind of themes in his life too.
I think he reacts to them totally differently though.
Yeah.
In my view.
Maybe
like he goes further to the I don't want to say promoting again, but like, you know, I'm Kanye, I'm the best, like whatever, like at all costs. Whereas Lauren is pointing to like saboteurs and like other, you know, other people's agendas bringing her down. She wasn't able to live up to the pressures of the second album, which, I mean, could happen to 3, but, like, if you have a 3 fixture, more likely to, like, at least turn something out, you know, even if it's not great, but that could live up to expectations.
I guess maybe I'm also looking just to see, like, she has clearly a lot of super ego, so...
A complete mystery. It's been 25 years since Lauren's iconic solo album, The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill, was released, and we still don't know if Lauren will ever grace us with another project.
Actually, I mean, this could point to 2 Wing 1 in the heart space too, the sort of self-punishment, self-exile sort of in the way that 4 can sort of do that, but 2's do it from like a different reason of like...
Well, 3, to me, what speaks against 3 fix is like 3s or like even 4 and 3s will like how do you put it, like self-recreate, like transform their image. Like, whereas she seems very much like, this is me, I'm doing me, I'm evolving on my own terms. I'm not going to do a big like image transformation in order to be successful or like get, you know, the kind of accolades that like I used to get or whatever. She's just kind of like going down her own path. And I think that can be underappreciated with 2-in-1. Like twos often, you know, are, you know, four is more cast as like the one going on their own path. But like, that's not true of 4-wing 3 in many ways. And like maybe 4-wing 5, but like 2-in-1 is like very much like has like a strong like inner sense of like who they are and like what they're doing. And they're not going to like redo their themselves image wise to, you know, get more likes or like more adoration.
Somebody was trashing her, and she wrote a whole Medium piece. And this does also speak to social self-promise to me in some ways. She got on her pulpit, although she's got the pulpit in her typing too. But I remained patient and quiet for a very long time, allowing people to talk, speculate, and project while keeping my nose to the grindstone, fighting for freedoms many folks aren't even aware matter. Yeah, okay, this is pretty super ego-y. The arrogance mm-hmm. of presumption that allows someone to think that they could have all the facts about another person's life and experience is truly remarkably presumptuous. People can sometimes confuse kindness for weakness and silence for weakness as well. When this happens, I have to speak up. I apologize for the delay in getting this posted. I was late in hearing about it. I understand this is long, but my last interview was over a decade ago. That's also interesting that like she's not going to do like the tour to like clear it up. Mm-hmm. She's got to do it. Like, yeah, I think you might be right about this, because I don't think she's, I can see 8, so I don't think she's 1 fixed.
Right. Yeah, look at this, like this one, starting with, I don't think most people, it goes like, I set the tone with every band that working for fame and accolades is a different walk than fighting for personal integrity and making art that doesn't compromise itself for money. You know, many people like would think that, or say something like that, but their actions don't necessarily align to like that point of view. But I think like you can see in her, the trajectory of her career, that she really didn't compromise.
Yeah, that's a good point, actually, because she just went and had a humble kind of life instead. Yeah, and this is sort of almost like weirdly pastoral, or I don't know if that's mm-hmm. the right word, but it's sort of like a godly sort of taking the higher. I mean, I think she's had some kind of like spiritual awakening, but the fact mm-hmm. that she like had it so young, I think does speak maybe typologically to. But these quotes are pretty super ego-y. Everything we do should be a result of our gratitude for what God has done for us. How are you going to win when you ain't right within? I consider myself a crayon and make me your favorite color, but one day you'll need me to complete your picture. That's some rejection.
Yeah.
It, tomorrow's always another day to make things right. And deep in my heart, the answer, it was in me, and I made up my mind to define my own destiny. Yeah, this is all very vision heavy, like very better mm-hmm. world. We can be better. I had to confront my fears and master my every demonic thought about inferiority, insecurity, or the fear of being Black, young, and gifted in the Western culture. Yeah, that sounds extra super ego rich. That's an interesting try then for her, or like an interesting overall configuration, like 6-wing 5, 8-wing 9, 2-wing 1. So mm-hmm. like triple gut, triple super ego. Mm-hmm. Ouch. Yeah, that kind of makes sense, actually. I think she's got to be social self-pres, though, no? Like, she doesn't really give any electricity, you know?
Yeah, social stuff press makes sense. I mean, that was the first vibe I got from her when I was started watching that speech. I was felt like she was just like so speaking out. I also saw 6 being 5, 8 being 9. I guess I thought maybe because like there's something about her that's like for a 6 being 5, 8 being 9, 2 being 1, like that's a pretty, I don't know what to say, like not harsh, like heavy, like, or something like trifics. Maybe she could be social sexual to account for some more of her like eccentricities and kind of lightness on her feet and like ability to improvise. But that was just a thought. I'm fine with social self-press.
Well, we can watch like a little bit more just to see if anything jumps out.
But wait a minute. Where are you going? Where are you headed? Because I'm going this way. Wait, what happened? I thought we were all on the, you know, and sometimes success can do that. Sometimes it really illuminates, you know, creative differences, spiritual differences, you know, emotional differences. And I, you know, just like a young person would think that, you know, the friends that you, my fifth grade friends are going to be my friends forever, you know, throughout high school, throughout. And it's not that they cease being your friends, but sometimes you just mature to a place and some people get there faster, some people don't, you know, and.
I guess that's another point is that she's very serious. Like she's always been very serious for her age. So, mm-hmm. And I could see, it's weird because 2 wing 3 is a totally different thing, but I could almost weirdly see it 6 wing 5 and 2 wing 1 and 8 being like kind of almost nerdier, like not nerdier in the like, hey, I'm a little geek kind of way, just in the sort of more book read focused on studies, like,
oh, yeah,
turned off by the entertainment industry. Yeah, mm-hmm. Good catch, Bisu. I would have probably just gone 3 wing 4 hard for her, but I'm waiting for her second instinct now.
You know, hopefully, ultimately, everyone catches up. But you know, it's really interesting because I didn't actually make a decision to be solo. It really just happened. I promise you that it's hard to explain, but you know, I'd intended to be in the group forever. Until I found myself in circumstances where I felt the inner desire to express myself freely and openly without any constraint, you know, without anybody saying, hey, you can't say that. That's not fly. You can't say that. People won't, you know what I mean? So, you know, the only way I could have done that was in doing a solo release. Well, the good part about it is I think that God...
That's kind of like a superego justification, I think, for wanting to go out on her own too, that I don't think a 3 fix would have, because it's like, I had to go out on my own.
Yeah.
I was outcast from heaven. I mean, I think this woman is down to business, you know. I don't really know that I'm going to be a sexual.
Yeah, I'm good with social self-press. I was trying to be open because, like, there is something about her, you know, when I, like compelling. In my, like, corner, like, in VV, we talk about, like, yin and yang. And there is something about her that, like, despite, like, 6.5 is, like, pretty yang in itself, but, like, she doesn't seem that yang, like, despite everything she says. So that's why I wondered about social sexual being like the yin, more like flowing, like not as like hard pushy. But I'm still getting social self-press more than social sexual, so I'm good with that.
Yeah. And I think, like, if she was social sexual, too, she'd probably be more more to-y, like there'd be more to readily available with like, I can help you. Sorry. Okay. Lauryn Hill, that was a surprise plot twist, but I feel good about that.
Me too.
Lauryn Hill, social self-pres, 6-wing 5, 8-wing 9, 2-wing 1.